Hello. The purpose of this presentation is to show you or to explain how to control the velocity of a joint in a software CoppeleSim VREP. And for that purpose, I have just simply created a very basic scene that I am going to explain. And we're going to do that by scripting. That means that we are going to use the regular API of Lua that we have available in the software. Okay. So, first thing, just simply I have created a base, cuboid, okay, which is acting as a base. Then I have a joint, which is called revolut underscore joint. This is the default name. And then I have another cuboid, which is actually with the shape of a bar, okay? And this example, as you can see, if we access to the dynamic properties of the objects, so this bar here is dynamic, okay? Which implies that in order for this simulation to properly work, we need to be, the joint needs to be in torque force mode or any other mode with a hybrid operation mode enabled, okay? So, indeed, if you access to the dynamic properties of the joint, you will see that we have a motor attached to it, so it's actuated, okay? And by default, the target velocity is zero, okay? So it will be stopped unless we modify this target velocity in our code. That's what we are actually going to do, okay? The control loop is not enabled, means that we are not doing a position control right now with this joint, okay? So yeah, this should be disabled, okay? So with that, I have created a script for you and I associate this script to the base. This is the common thing to do. And if we access to the script, I'm going to explain how it works, okay? So, first thing you see is that we are basically or only using the init function, because this is a very simple example, in which at the beginning what we do is we get the object handle of revolut underscore joint object, which is this one here, okay? And this object handle, so this name has to match with this name here, and remember that I already mentioned this function here, this object handle will return a number, which is indeed the handle. And this number is something internal of the program, we don't care about the number itself, it's something that the program needs in order to properly, let's say, modify the velocity, okay? For instance, if we go for the next instruction here, what we're doing is we are setting the joint target velocity. So actually we are modifying this target velocity parameter that I showed you before, and we can see exactly how this instruction works. Okay, so if we right click there and we click on open reference there, we have this documentation about this instruction here, and it's basically saying what I have already said to you, that is setting the intrinsic target velocity and works for non-spherical joints, means that it works for revolut joints and prismatic joints, okay, both of them, okay? And, this command only makes sense when the joint is in mode torque force, okay? So that's exactly what we're doing, okay? And if you take a look to the synopsis, this function here specs two numbers indeed. The first one is the object handle, that is the joint handle that we are going to set the target velocity. And the second one is also a number and is the target velocity. And the description of these parameters is actually, as you can see here, describe it in the C description of the parameters. So first one is the object handle and the second one is the target velocity. And this target velocity could be the linear velocity if we are using a prismatic joint, or the angular velocity if we're doing a revolut joint, okay? So depends on the type. And in a case of revolut joints, the units are radians per second, while for prismatic joints are meters per second, okay? Well, this function returns a number. In our case, we are not using this number, but if something is wrong, we could always see if there's something wrong, because it returns a minus one after calling this function. Let's say that the joint is not in torque force mode, for instance, and that will return a minus one, okay? So, yeah, okay, so with this example, we have everything we need right now to run the simulation, and we will see how it works, okay? So at the beginning, indeed, without our script, the bar won't move because the target velocity is zero, but we are setting at the beginning that target velocity to be 0.1 radians per second. So if we play run, we see that is spinning, in this case, counterclockwise, okay? We can stop, and we can modify this and increase the speed, for instance, doubling it. And it's rotating faster, okay? And we can also reverse the rotation direction, so with a minus, so it will spin, in this case, clockwise. Okay, so in this video I have explained you how to work with joints, or how to program joints that can be controlled with the velocity. Thank you very much.